Hi guys, welcome to my third video of the virtual working series. In the first one, we saw how managers can effectively manage their employees who are working remotely, and the second one showed ways in which you can make your virtual working effective. If you missed watching those videos, the links are in the description box below for your easy access. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, why not do that before we get on to this video. Today I'm going to be talking about some online team bonding activities which you can try out with your colleagues for connecting with them while working from home. So let's get started. The first one to try out is video games. So if your bunch is into video gaming, you can try out an online platform called Steam. It has amazing built-in video games, any of which you can choose to play. For example, one of them is called Overcooked. It is a cooking simulation game which involves 1 to 4 players. Each team has to prepare a variety of meals while overcoming various obstacles in their way, and the meals should be prepared before the buying customers storm out in a huff. Now, it's a time-bound thing, so it will definitely keep the players on their feet and will require them to work as a team to win. Overcooked can be found on other websites as well. A simple Google search should help you. And to communicate between the team players while you are playing, you can use an online chat system called Discord. It's very popular within the video gaming community. There are a lot of other online video games as well, for example, Taboo, Pool, any of which you can play. So video games is the way to go if your team is completely into playing. The second thing that you can try out are quizzes. There's a really amazing app named Kahoot, wherein one of you as the team member can host and create a quiz online and open it out to members. Now, it can be a movie quiz, a tech quiz, or anything at all. The user interface is really interactive and quite colorful. How it works is in the fastest finger first manner. So for each question, the person who answers first gets 10 points, the person who answers second gets 9 points, and the third one gets 8, and so on. And every question has a timer, so it is bound to get your team members really up on their feet and can bring about a spirit of healthy competition within the team members. The third kind of game that you can play is called Codenames. Now, it is a board game wherein there are multiple words placed on the board. The online version looks something like this. And there are two teams of 3 to 4 players each. Each team resembles a particular color on the board and has a spy master who gives out a one word clues to point at different words on the board. Only the spy master can see which word belongs to their team, and the team does not know. So they have to guess the words based on the clues given out by the spy master. Some of the words are really linked to the words of the other team as well. So the spy masters have to be really careful and creative when giving out hints so as to prevent their team from guessing a word which belongs to the other team. Now, this is one game which requires a lot of thought and creativity and thinking out of the box kind of a quality, and also to understand what the spy master from your team might be thinking when he gave out the clues. So it really helps you understand and think from that person's perspective, really brings about bonding within the team members. The other kind of games that you can play online are Pictionary, Tombola, Charades, and many others which are available online. But my favorite of all of the team bonding activities has to be the Happy Hour, wherein the entire team decides at a particular time of the day, wherein they all get on together on a video chatting platform. They all switch on their cameras, have a drink in their hand. It could be tea, coffee, juice, or any drink of your choice, and just gossip with the team members, just like you would do at coffee breaks when you are in office. The other thing that you could try during your virtual hours is to share your childhood pictures with the entire team, and you could play a simple game of Guess Who. So you'll all get to see some funny pictures, some exciting, enthusiastic pictures of people from their childhood memories, and really helps to connect and bond with them beyond all your work hours. And in fact, why just stop at your teams? You can try these out with your family and friends as well. So what are you waiting for? Go ahead, try these out, share your experiences in the comment section. And if you like this video, please click on the like button and click on subscribe. This is Madhuri Verma, and I'll see you next week with yet another video. Until then, thank you for watching.